Hello everyone, welcome back to Learn Electronics with Associated by ProfEC.com. Let's distinguish between intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductor, then extended to P and N type semiconductors. Before this start, I strongly recommending that to watch how semiconductors are working video. In that video, semiconductor functioning was demonstrated by using silicon atoms alone via silicon crystal formation. It also named as pure semiconductor because of it does not having any impurities. Intrinsic is defined by being part of the character of something. Silicon crystals, semiconductors, conduction part is the character of silicon atom alone. Fulfilling the, all the need of the definition, this kind of semiconductor is called intrinsic semiconductor. As a result, this is in slow in nature for conduction due to lack of electrons and energy to conduct. Application also limited since this property. To accomplish higher number of electrons, adding impurities or attempt in the intrinsic semiconductor. As a result was astonishing, laid path to uncountable application and conduction scenario. It was named that pouring or adding impurities to the pure semiconductor process is called doping. Impurities means other than the silicon atom, it will be considered as impurity. On the other hand, in germanium crystal or semiconductor, silicon would be impurity. Let's refocus on the silicon semiconductor itself. While adding impurities to this pure semiconductor, it will become extrinsic semiconductor, which have better conduction than earlier one. To be precious, only group 3 and group 5 atoms are taken for pouring. For standard semiconductors, group 3 atoms are containing 3 electrons in the outer orbit. In the meantime, group 5 atoms are containing 5 electrons in the outer orbit. At the process of doping, group 3 atom will start to bond with the silicon atom's outer electrons. Only 3 covalent bonds are possible to create for every silicon atom. As a result, an electron would be left alone in silicon, which forcibly create empty space known as a hole in the dopant atom, just an empty space in the group 3 atom. Jumping into other atoms to do the conduction like the electron does, positive charge conduction is demonstrated, that is the hole conduction. This type of hole conducting semiconductors are called P-type semiconductors. If dopant from the group 5 will have one electron freely at the end of the doping process, same like while we are doping the group 5 electrons in the silicon, silicon will have the 4 covalent bonds, one electron will be missed out in the dopant. At room temperature, free electrons can move freely through the semiconductor. That is negative charge conduction because it's done by electrons. This category of semiconductor is named by N-type semiconductor. I hope you have better vision about intrinsic, extrinsic and P-type and N-type semiconductors. You can digitally upload this content by doing like, dislike, comment and share. Thanks for learning. See you on the flip side. Love you all electronics. Thanks. Bye-bye.